Hello all, now let's discuss about the drugs which inhibit nucleic acid or DNA in a bacteria or antimicrobials which inhibit DNA inhibitors. So they are divided into two DNA inhibitors. The first drug is the drug which will cause direct DNA or nucleic acid damage. Okay, direct DNA damage. Now, how these drugs will cause direct DNA damage? These drugs inside the bacteria, they will form a free radical of nitric oxide. They forms nitric oxide free radical, and this nitric oxide, it causes direct DNA damage. Okay, it causes direct DNA damage. Among them, we have the first drug as nitroimidazoles. Okay, nitroimidazoles. Among this nitroimidazole, we will discuss a very famous drug, that will be metronidazole. And the second class of drug we have is nitrofurantoin. Okay, nitrofurantoin. So these drugs, they cause direct DNA damage by formation of nitric oxide free radicals. The radicals of nitric oxide will damage DNA. Now the second we have is DNA gyrase and topoisomerase 4 inhibitor. Okay, topoisomerase 4 inhibitor. Now this enzyme, DNA gyrase and topoisomerase 4, they are required for DNA synthesis. Okay, DNA replication occurs because of these enzyme. The drug which inhibit them are, you will write, fluoroquinolones. Okay, fluoroquinolones. And the last drug we have is novobiosin. Okay, so this is the complete list of the drugs which generally inhibit DNA and DNA gyrase. Okay, now you must remember one point. These first two drugs, they are bactericidal drug. Okay, they are cidal drug. They cause complete killing. While these two drugs in the last, they are bacteriostatic drug. Okay, they are bacteriostatic drug. Okay, so let's discuss each of these drugs one by one. So let's start with the first one, that is nitroimidazoles. Okay, let's make a heading, nitroimidazoles. Now, among nitroimidazoles, we have various drugs. The most famous drug we have is metronidazole. So we have various drugs like metronidazole. Okay, you'll write other drugs like tinidazole, ornidazole. Okay, you'll write cetranidazole. And lastly, you will write secnidazole. So as you can see, these drugs, they are ending with a similar word, that is dazole. Okay, dazole word is coming. So you can easily remember. Okay, now you must write that this metronidazole overall is the shortest acting drug we have. It is the shortest acting drug, and this secnidazole overall is the longest acting drug we have. Longest acting. And cetranidazole, I will tell you that it will be the only drug that does not cause. It is the only drug that does not cause one side effect known as disulfiram-like reaction. It will not cause disulfiram-like reaction. All other drug will be causing this side effect. Okay, so keeping this thing in mind, let's see what is the pharmacokinetic. These drugs can be given orally as well as IV. Okay, and let's see the uses. Okay, for uses, you can write one mnemonic, that is get D gap in metro. Metro means metronidazole is the drug of choice. This group is the drug of choice. So the first use is G. You'll write they are the drug of choice for giardiasis. They are the drug of choice for giardiasis. Now the drug of choice for giardiasis instead of metronidazole has become single dose tinidazole. That is, single dose tinidazole is the most preferred drug for giardiasis. Then you will write E for entamoeba histolytica infection. Entamoeba histolytica, remember, it causes amoebiasis. It causes amoebiasis. So it is given in both amoebic dysentery. Drug of choice is metronidazole and its brothers. And you can write hepatic amoebic abscess. Okay. So the drug of choice is metronidazole like drug. Third, you will write T for metronidazole is the drug of choice for Trichomonas vaginalis infection. It's a very important question because it is the most common pathogen which causes vaginal discharge in females. Okay, Trichomonas vaginalis, drug of choice is metronidazole. D for it is the drug of choice for one worm known as Dracunculus. Dracunculus worm, which is also known as Guinea worm. Okay. Now next G stand for, it is the drug of choice for Gardnerella, which is also known as bacterial vaginosis. Again, the drug of choice is metronidazole. Okay. The drug of choice is metronidazole. Now A for, you will write, they are the drug of choice for anaerobic infection. Everywhere they are the drug of choice, okay? Anaerobic infection, they are the drug of choice metronidazole. Like, example is, you'll write bacteroids. Bacteroids fragilis. You can write other infections like Clostridium. Tetanus. Clostridium botulinae, which causes botulinum toxin. Because they are anaerobic bacteria, drug of choice is metronidazole. Then you will write, they are also the used in pseudomembranous colitis, which is caused by Clostridium perfringens. Again, an anaerobic bacteria. Sorry, Clostridium difficile infection. Again, an anaerobic bacteria. And lastly, it is also given in peptic ulcers due to Helicobacter pylori. Helicobacter pylori peptic ulcer. So these are the uses of metronidazole. So you'll write a mnemonic, get the gap in metro. G for giardiasis, E for entamoeba, T for Trichomonas vaginalis, Dracunculus, etc. Okay, now let's see what are the side effects of metronidazole we have. So metronidazole, the most common side effect is dysgeusia. Dysgeusia means altered taste sensation. It causes metallic taste. The mouth becomes metallic taste, it causes dysgeusia. Second, you will write that metronidazole like drug, they also cause. Metronidazole like drug, they also cause dark or brown colored urine. Brown colored urine. Third, you also write they cause disulfiram like reaction in chronic alcoholics. So that is why they are avoided in active drinkers, alcoholics. Okay. Except we know is cetranidazole. Cetranidazole does not cause. Now why it is important? Because amoebiasis like infection, they are very common in alcoholics. In alcoholics, metronidazole may cause dangerous disulfiram like reaction, and amoebiasis drug of choice is again metronidazole. So it should be used very cautiously. And last point you will write, it may cause seizures. Okay. So these are the side effects of metronidazole. Understood?